car.
It's a hard country.
When it turns off our mind, is something that you won't forget now, so everybody will be safe and be heard properly. Thank you.
These idols are an abomination to God. If it is offensive to God, it's offensive to me.
I think that the statue of Mago is a good economic attraction here in Cottonwood. Personally, I think that the park, Earth Park, and the Mago statue to me represent the fact that all people on this earth are one people.
I know the real matter that the board has here tonight concerns this conditional use permit and the Mago statue, and I'd like to state that I personally am opposed to it.
I'm here in support of Mago statue and park since she represents the earth. We are all reminded to respect and cherish the earth.
If you allow it to continue to expand and add hotels and restaurants and riding stables and bicycle rentals, what can you call it? Can you call it a church or is it a business? And if you allow them a 50-foot sign to attract people to their business, then how are you going to stop the next guy that has a hardware store and says, well, I want to put up a 50-foot hammer? It's my business. I need to attract people. A 4-foot hammer over here isn't going to attract anybody. This is the point. We have to maintain and we have to enforce our codes. If you don't...
And it will attract many people from the many places, and it will be very good, beneficial for the country economy.
A few years ago, I was helping a business in town get started, and in doing so, made 6 36-inch flamingos to put in the flower beds out in the front. They were in keeping with the design and motif of the business. A few days later, planning and zoning told us that we had to remove them because they were an eyesore. It's incredible that you are the only planning and zoning commission in the United States gullible enough to give them permission to invade the most beautiful country in Arizona. And what about the Kokopellis and the troll, or whatever it's called, I'm not sure. What code did they come under? The Kokopelli is a mythological being that went from Indian village to Indian village, blowing his horn and impregnating all the females that were in the village. How does Mr. Lee and his followers brain weave that in his control?
The one is between the earth and me, and the one is among us, are very obvious and intangible. And I'm sure most of the visitors to this park will feel the same as I do. That's why I'm in support of this Mago Earth Park and Mago statue. Thank you.
Thank you.
I would like to make a correction first of all. A gentleman who came up here before said that he saw me on CNN as the spokesperson for Tap Lunch. That is incorrect. I am the spokesperson for Dharma Yoga. These are two separate entities. Dharma Yoga is a for-profit entity. Tap Lunch is not. I donate money to Tap Lunch. I have volunteered at Mago Earth Park. But it is not a business.
The Mago statue really is a sign, according to the City of Cottonwood zoning ordinance.
Why won't they only put a sign up at my church bigger than a 3x5? I'm talking about the City Council now and the Planning Commission. If you want to be just, then be just. Do not make exceptions. Because you and I will be judged for the decisions we make.
And I would like to show my support for the Mago Earth Park.
I hope that you'll allow it to stand as it is. I haven't seen any car wrecks happen. God hasn't striked the earth. We haven't had any plagues come upon us because of our insulting of God.
was permitted a small sign in front of my business, and I was not allowed to put it on a tall pedestal. I would strongly urge you to not only consider the removal of that Mago statue, but also the placing of that sign at a grade level, so that the intention of the sign laws are followed.
Mr. Chairman, members of the Commission, my name is Boyce McDonald. I'm with the Interim Land Use Manager for Yavapai County Development Services. And I'd like to offer Development Services position on this land use issue here before you tonight. While this proposed project is not within Yavapai County jurisdiction, the county appreciates the opportunity to review this application. It appears the proposed uses and site plan are accessory uses to the Mago Retreat Center that is located 11 miles out Billgrave Road and within Yavapai County jurisdiction. At present, Yavapai County has served a notice of violation and summons to hearing in regards to uses that are taking place at the Mago Retreat Center that are not allowed by right, illegal uses in the RCU 2A zoning district, residential single family. This proposal is approved. Yavapai County would consider it an accessory use to an illegal use occurring within Yavapai County jurisdiction. Thank you.
Not just freedom of religion, but you have freedom of expression. You're trying to dictate what art is. That's been debated for centuries.
My God hates idols, and I totally oppose it. And it's not going to bring blessings. It's not going to bring financial success. No, no. It's not going to bring that at all. So check your Holy Bible, and you'll find out what idols bring to a nation. I love you all. God bless you.
I'm rather fond of the statue, but I think that it should stand or fall on legal grounds. A great number of people have raised overly religious objections to the statue, and I think that deserves a lucid response. I think that if we are prepared to attribute ill intent to different people simply because they express themselves in ways that we are not accustomed to, and we have begun to demonize them, and if we're willing to take this step, there is no end to the atrocities we will be willing to commit.
My first inclination is that this is a classic. It's easier to beg forgiveness than it is to get permission. When they came to us and applied for this caretaker house, as they put it, the manufactured home was already up on the property. It was in place. It was hooked up to the rest of the world. Then they came for the conditional use permit. And it seems like over the last 3 years, it has been do it and then come for permission. The original request was a caretaker house, and if I recall correctly, at that meeting after it was over with and we had approved it, my understanding is that it immediately changed within 5 to 10 minutes after the adjournment of the meeting to now become a shuttle stop. To my knowledge, it has never been a caretaker house. It has always been a welcome center and an office. I have a motion. I have a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The ayes have it. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen.